I feel like the real issue need to be fixed, which is the 17-year-old walking around with a gun. That's a real problem in Baltimore. And as y'all can see, the crime rate, put it in the car, Denise. Like, come on now. The crime rate with teens in Baltimore, that's why I'm glad they doing the curfew thing.
Just because I didn't see the evidence, you know, I wasn't there, so I mean, I can't say that he had a gun or I don't even know the whole situation. I just know shooting somebody in the back is wrong, in my opinion, you know?
Well, I can say he had a gun because I saw it in the video and I read it in the police report. That is just, those are just some of the reactions to the announcement, 530 Club and Bryan Nehman yesterday, that Baltimore District Judge Kent Bowles made the decision that instead of getting an ankle bracelet and sending a teenager home to home detention, that teenager, 17 years old, is charged with 9 different offenses, including first and second degree assault, a range of firearms crimes, and no, he's not going home. He's on a no bail status because when he was ordered to put a gun that had an extended magazine on it down by a Baltimore City police officer, he didn't do it. Mm-hmm. And yes, he did turn around in the video, and you don't know what he's going to do when he turned around, and he was shot by that officer. I just think, Bryan, that this particular decision, and, you know, people say you shouldn't send messages through the criminal justice system and that type of thing, but I think this is an important message. When the police tell you to stop, stop. When they tell you to put a gun down, put a gun down.
Yeah.
I just think it's an important message.
Oh, well, I mean, it is an important message. I have to say I'm a little bit surprised by it. I thought he was going to be released back to his parents.
Particularly after he was shot.
Yeah, right. And at not being charged with anything at the time. So they were trying to work on figuring out what exactly they were going to charge him with. Obviously, there's a slew of things they could have charged him with. I don't have a big problem with it because
no.
I think you're absolutely right. You know what? You know, keep the woman there who was interviewed on the street. She's right too. You know, these guys who won't carry guns. What the hell are you taking it out for? What the hell are you taking a gun out for with a cop around and running from a cop? You know, with a gun
people,
in your hand.
Let's remind people what happened. It wasn't like the police car just rolls up, officer jumps out and starts chasing somebody. This particular police officer was having a conversation at 1:25 in the afternoon, sitting on steps in Shipley Hill, southwest part of the city, with other teenagers, who, by the way, weren't in school either. Mm-hmm. We're talking right. about a school day, yeah. May the 11th, a school day, when they're standing around talking. As they're talking, the police officer, who's part of a elite group of that out there, looking for, you know, gun crimes, that type of thing. He's talking, he notices, according to his report, what looks like a gun underneath the shirt of this young man. So he goes up and tries to talk to him. The young man starts walking away first. Officer pursues, you see the body camera. Mm-hmm. He walks towards him. He said something to him. At that point, the teenager just took off, started running. The officer, and you can hear it in the tape, says, stop, stop, put the gun down, put the gun down. What else do you need to know?
Yeah, right.
What else do you need to know in this situation?
I mean, he didn't understand the orders.
Yeah, okay.
So before you understand, you know, he thought...
He didn't understand water was wet until it... And some teenagers need to understand. There are consequences.
Yeah. And again, I mean, we act like this kid is just like the sweetest person in the world who was just doing nothing wrong, just on a beautiful Sunday afternoon.
Just carrying a gun.
It was during a school day. He doesn't even live in the city. He's
right.
there. He's got a gun. Had apparently been there for several days in a row. And is running away from a police officer with a gun, not only in his hand, but outside of his body, you know, kind of, you know,
and
running
turned
with it.
Around.
Yeah, I mean, that
while
is,
he was running.
That is of question, but I think that, you know, police certainly have made that case. That's their point of view
My
from
eyes,
it. The defense
look,
doesn't.
The eyeball
see it that
test
way.
Tells me what I see. He's running. As the officers put it down, he turns. And as he turns, you can clearly see the gun in his hand. And my question at the time, Bryan, it still is today. For those who would want to question it, whether it's the witness there, whatever, is the officer supposed to wait till his body turns completely around and he gets shot?
No, he's
is
not.
That what he's supposed to
he's
wait
not.
For?
And your expectation as a criminal, because you are a criminal when you are running away from police with a gun in
at
your hand.
At a lawful command, stop.
And he's yelling stop multiple times. Your expectation is you're going to get shot.
Probably.
I mean,
probably.
I mean, that's the way it
or
is.
Or shot at.
Or
if you
shot
don't get
at. Right.
Either way.
And so I just, you know, for the life of me, don't understand why this has been made into this, oh, my God, what are police doing in Baltimore again,
you know,
kind
what?
Of story.
Because we are living, once again, in the post-George Floyd era where everything, no matter what police officers do, is somehow under the lens of police brutality or whatever. And I'm not going to live in that world. Mm. I want a world where a 17-year-old, and by the way, we have no idea because he's a juvenile and his records are sealed, what kind of record he has to bring to the table in all this discussion. I want to live in a world where a police officer is protecting the other people in Shipley Hill. Who knows what might have happened with the day-to-day folks in Shipley Hill if you don't arrest this kid.
Right.
You don't know.
Right. Now, he was charged with assault and first-degree assault. We don't have any details about that. We don't know where the assault took place or who the assault was on, right?
I mean, I don't know.
That one's a little weird.
It could be the fact that he pointed a gun, and some people have said it's maybe a stretch for first-degree assault. Here's what I know. He's got 9 charges against him, 9 offenses in this thing. And to me, the whole thing of the judge saying you get a no-bail status should tell all the other young people running around with guns, you might not go home. There's a possibility that if you carry a gun and you aren't, you know, appropriately conducting yourself, you're going to stay in jail.
Yeah. What I do like about this case, honestly, is that I feel like police have not backed down.
Right.
And I thought
they
would. I thought maybe the judge would in this particular case. Maybe they would only charge him with, one or two different crimes. But they are basically saying, no, this guy's a problem.
He is.
And was a problem that day. And we are going to go after him everything we could. Because you shoot a guy and he's in the hospital for a long period of time. The charges aren't there first. And what are they going to do? How many different charges are going to get with? And they say, nope, you know what? No.
No.
This guy is a menace to society. We don't want him released. We're going to charge him with as many crimes as we possibly can. And the judge has looked at this and said, you know what? It's not safe to put him back out there on the street, despite the fact that he has pretty significant injuries.
Don't run. That's my whole thing. I'm sorry to say, the injuries don't bother me as long as, you know, running for the police bothers me. Here's where I believe this is. Let's use a little bit of intuition here. I believe one of the reasons that Judge Kent Bowles, I want to say his name because we always say judges' names negatively. I want to say it positively. Thank you, Baltimore District Judge Kent Bowles. Maybe he's seen this kid's record.
I think you got a better feeling about that.
Maybe he's seen this kid's record.
I think that's right.
And maybe it's a better situation for us that this kid is not in home detention. And I just wish, Bryan, this comes into the play again. Delegate Dahlia Attar's legislation. We don't have to, well, we know this kid's name now, Mekhi Franklin, I think is his kid's name. So we know his name, but outside of knowing this kid's name, what kind of offenses does he have in the past? Don't you think we need to know that?
It'd be nice.
Does he have gun charges? How about this way? Does he have gun charges in the past? That's what I'd like to know.
How many?
How about that?
How about just tell me how many charges?
Exactly.
How many times has he been arrested before? How many times has he been charged with a crime, you know?
And the gun charges particularly stick out to me because that would suggest that the reason he had that gun on him and was not willing to throw it down is because he had prior issues with guns.
Yeah.
Because most kids, you know, put the gun down, they kind of get startled. He didn't look startled. He looked pretty comfortable running with that gun in his hand.
Yeah. And then, you know, this woe is me story about how he's working to graduate and get a driver's license and all these things.
Yeah, he's in 11th grade. Why isn't he in school in 11th grade? That's what I want to know.
That's right.
He's an 11th grader, if some mom said. Why isn't he in school?
Right. How many days has he been truant?
Right.
Did you give him a pass for the day that he missed when he was shot by a police officer? What did he get on that day? Why was he exactly in Baltimore City on that particular day?
Well, I am ready, Bryan, because something tells me that we'll hear this for the next few days with this no bail status. All of the stories about how horrible the criminal justice system is to keep a 17-year-old shot in the back, because that's still, that narrative is still out there, shot in the back, running away from police in jail. I'm saying 17-year-olds, don't run from the police, obey lawful commands, and don't have a gun in your hand. And then you don't end up in this situation.
Well, the other part about it is, too, that the police were harassing him.
Oh, sure.
And all the complaints, too, about police don't get out of their cars. Nobody's doing anything anymore. There is no policing happening in Baltimore. You get a cop who's out of the car engaging people, sees an issue, and now he's the problem for believing that this guy had a gun, right? Because he had characteristics of carrying a weapon, which, by the way, the cop was right. He did have a weapon.
And by the way, what does this say about State's Attorney Avin Bates and the fact that his office is pursuing 9 charges?
Yeah.
Maybe the State's Attorney's office is trying to say, don't carry a gun, mm-hmm. don't run from the police, obey lawful commands. Maybe that's a new tone from State's Attorney Avin Bates. I don't see him in front of microphones mm-hmm. talking about young person,
mm-hmm.
as we might have seen with another State's Attorney.